But you know, when somebody dies in the hills of County Kerry, the ritual of the wake hasn't changed for 1,000 years. Imagine, in a little thatched cottage, they have the kitchen table and they cover it with a white sheet and a silk pillow, and they lay the remains out on the table and all the neighbours come in to pay their last respects. Such a man lying on the table is Seamus O'Shaughnessy, passed on, deceased, gone over, demised, in transit, and he's stone dead as well. Suddenly, two of the legs of the table caved in and O'Shaughnessy slid onto the floor, and Muldoon says, "My God, what are we going to do?" And Murphy says, "Well, we'll have to level him up somehow." He says, "We'll put his head on a chair, we'll put his feet on another chair, and we'll push a chair in underneath him, lift him up and level him out." Muldoon says, "A good idea." Murphy says, "Leave it to me." Murphy looked around at the people at the wake and he says, "Can we have 3 chairs for the corpse?" And they all went, "Hip, hip, hooray!" This fella Hennessy is a rich farmer from County Galway. He's plenty of money and he had this dog and he loved it passionately. Anyway, the dog died and he went to see Father Murphy in the church and he says, "Father, the dog is dead." And the priest says, "I'm sorry to hear that." He says, "Father, now, the money is no object and I want to give the dog a good send-off." He says, "Will you say a little mass for the dog?" And the priest says, "I'm sorry to tell you, but," he says, "there's a new denomination, we don't say mass for animals," he says, "but there's a new denomination open about 20 miles down the road." Anyway, I'll start that one again. This fella Hennessy is a rich farmer. Yeah, I have to start it again. You see, I'm recording this, so yeah, I have to start all over again. You see, you have to laugh as if you never heard it before. This fella Hennessy is a rich farmer from County Galway, plenty of money. And he had a dog and he loved this dog passionately. Anyway, the dog died and he went to see Father Murphy in the church. He says, "Father, the dog is dead." The priest says, "I'm sorry to hear that." He says, "Father, now the money is no object and I want to give the dog a good send-off." He says, "Will you say a little mass for the dog?" And the priest says, "I'm sorry to tell you, but we don't say mass for animals." But he said, "There's a new denomination open about 20 miles down the road." He says, "And God knows what they're up to." He says, "If you could down and talk to them, maybe they'll be able to arrange some kind of a service for the dog." He says, "I'm going down this very day, Father, and I'll speak to him." He says, "By the way, Father," he says, "if I give them £60,000, would that be enough?" He says, "Why didn't you tell me the dog was a Catholic?" This fella Murphy, by the way, is a terrible hypochondriac. He always thought there was something wrong with him. His uncle was the same. He was the worst hypochondriac in Ireland. When he died, on his tombstone, he had on his epitaph, and it read, "Now will you believe I'm sick?" But anyway, he'd do anything, by the way, to make himself younger. And he saw pills advertised in the local newspaper. Pills to make him 50 years younger. And he sent for some, and he got 5 of them. And when he got them, he forgot about them, and he left. He left him lying around the house, and a month later he went to America to work, and he was there for a year. And after a year he wrote to say he was coming home and to meet him at the railway station. So in a little village in Ireland he stepped off the train. There's a lovely woman standing there with a little baby carriage beside her. He says, "Well, who are you?" She says, "I'm your mother." He says, "Good God," he says, "how could you be my mother?" She says, "You know those pills you left lying around the house to make you 50 years younger? Well," she says, "I took one of them and look at me. My God," he says, "I can't believe it. It's fantastic." He says, "Who's that in the baby carriage?" He says, "Your father. He took 2. This fella, Sullivan, he got a job in the Museum of Archaeology. And his job was to stand beside a 30-foot skeleton of a dinosaur and explain all about it. So anyway, this group of students came into the museum and they were admiring the specimen, and this fella, one of the students, said, "Sullivan," he says, "how old is the skeleton?" And Sullivan said, "It's 3 million years and 7 months old." And the student was amazed. He said, "That's incredible." He said, "How can you pinpoint the age and the time so accurately?" And Sullivan said, "When I came to work here, that was 3 million years old, and I'm here 7 months." This fella O'Toole, he lived in County Kerry and he had a cat. And he loved this cat, and one day he said to his brother Mike, "I'm up to Dublin for a few days on business and I want you to take care of the cat while I'm gone." And Mike says, "I will." And 3 days go by and he phoned home. He says, "Mike, how is the cat?" Mike says, "The cat is dead." "My God," he says, "did you have to tell me like that?" Mike says, what other way would I tell you that the cat is dead? Well, he says, you could have said anything. He says, you could have broken the news gradually to me. You could have said that the cat was up on the roof, maybe. Up on the roof and the fire brigade were trying to get it down. You could have said that. The next night when I phoned, you could have said they got the cat, but when they were taking it down, they let it fall and it was badly injured when it hit the ground. The next night I phoned, you could have said the doctors tried every way to save the cat, but it was no good and the cat died. He said, had you told me that way, it wouldn't have been such a shock to me. He said, by the way, how's mother? He said, well, she's up on the roof.